All right, it's hard to believe, but 2 years ago, $800 billion in assets were seized from two Bear Stearns hedge funds.
A lot has happened in that time. Well, this, of course, roiled the credit markets and marks the unofficial beginning of the credit crisis. We have Brian Luke here to discuss the current state of this two-year-old crisis. Hard to believe it's 2 years old. Take it away, Brian.
Absolutely. But according to Citigroup strategist John Fenn, it's time to put another candle in the crisis cake. And really, to put this all in perspective, I want to focus on two things, really just the issuance and the level of it and the cost of borrowing. So let's first take a look at the issuance. And we want to bring up a chart that shows the 07, 08, and 09 issuance. That big number in 07, 148 million, that was actually half of that, or actually 100 million of that came in the first half. So that was before the birthday of the credit crisis. 2008, you see how it dried up. And then 2009, we're almost at the same level that you see in aggregate of 2008. So you can see it's really growing and picking up steam in 09.
The question is, is that a good thing or are people suckers again?
Yeah, that's really, it depends on who you're talking about. And there's a couple different names I want to point out who's actually been able to tap these high yield credit markets. And the first one is the largest commercial real estate services company, CB Richard Ellis. Yesterday, they raised $450 million in eight-year notes. It's actually a yield of 12.25%.
Commercial real estate, there's a place you want to invest right now.
However, yeah, there's high-yield borrowers and lending them money. And the second one is Limited Brands, and a lot of people know them from Victoria's Secret, the brand they own.
Now, Matt doesn't know them at all.
Not aware.
There's a place you definitely want to invest right now.
Well, if you want, they're selling $500 million of bonds today, and the price talk hasn't actually officially closed, but the price talk's around 9% yield to maturity.
Based, by the way, in the great state of Columbus, Ohio. The great state of Ohio in Columbus, I should say.
All right, so Brian, where does it kind of put them in context of the overall high yield market?
Yeah, I mean, they're pretty good barometers of what you see, but when you look at the high yield market in aggregate, I want to show you the Barclays Capital high yield spread, and that's the incremental yield you get over treasuries. Right now, we're about 9%. The average for this credit crisis is about 6%, so they still got to come in a little ways on the decade. But right now, we're right about average.
All right. Brian, thanks very much for joining us.